No investor will come and spend billions of dollars here trying to establish a factory if at any time the government can just wake up and say we are expropriating a factory without compensation. So I think we need to set the record straight about the issue of property rights so that the investors have confidence that their investment is safe in this country. So it was June 16 again, and the president had to make a speech. The emphasis this time was on youth unemployment, which is, by the way, has been the case for the last, I don't know how many decades. It's just getting worse and worse every day. I think we are currently now sitting at 64% youth unemployment. However, there's these new apps that the president presented. Apparently, they're gonna solve this 64% youth unemployment somehow, which is very interesting to me. These apps are meant to connect the job seekers, which is mostly the youth, to the opportunities. And it was said that they are zero rated, so that means you can access them for free via your phone, regardless of the network that you use. So who knows, maybe this can turn out to be a great thing. But I just have an issue, because the reason for unemployment is not because people are not able to access opportunities. It's simply because there's no opportunities out there. There are no companies hiring. So I just wonder how this new app is going to solve all these problems. It would be wonderful if it does, but obviously it won't, because there's just no opportunities that unemployed people need to be connected with, because they simply do not exist. And it just occurred in my mind that I wonder how much was spent on these apps as well, because last time, some time ago, we had spent 40 million rands just developing a website for some municipality in Northwest. Some few years ago. So who knows, maybe those people who developed these apps are millionaires already. There was also talks about the 12 or 11 billion rand stimulus that's going to help create jobs for the youth. You know, there's this tendency of politicians to want to splash out money to any societal problem, as if money is going to make the problems disappear. So I just wonder how this stimulus is going to work. I don't have the details yet, but I'm aware that there is presidential intervention program that is running with some private companies. So I just hope it yields some result. But my point is that every time there's a problem and the government intervenes, then it means that some bureau somewhere must be established, or an existing bureau must be expanded to be able to run this new program. So every time the government tries to solve a problem, a bureau or a government agency must be formed or expanded so that they're able to execute this new program. So more bureaus or more government agencies means more government spending. So usually a lot of money is spent establishing these bureaus to help the poor or to help the youth or to help small businesses, but nothing actually comes out of it. There's no tangible success that anyone can point and say it came because of this bureau or because of this agency. That's a problem with government intervention. It just increases the scope of government, and that always necessitates the expansion of bureaus. Of course, that comes at a cost. So what it means is that sometime in future, the taxes may need to be raised to cover the expenses of this new initiative for the youth. But I doubt if anything at all will come out of it, because jobs are created not by government, but by private businesses. All that the government needs to do is to create an enabling environment for people to come and invest their money in the country to start factories here and absorb people into those factories. You cannot create employment out of thin air. You know, there was a couple of numbers that were thrown around, the opportunities that were said to have been created since the start of COVID. Most of that, of course, it's what I call statistical illusions, because I'm aware of a couple of people who got the 3 months contracts to work in public school to be teachers' assistants, but that job was, you know, done after 3 months. So it looks good on paper, but actually doesn't exist in reality. There seem to be a lot of emphasis also on training and skills development. This is crazy because there's a lot of people who are skilled, highly skilled, well trained, well educated, who just can't find jobs. So there's this emphasis as if the people who are sitting at home, they're sitting at home because they don't have skills or they do not have the right training. That is not the case. So I think we are busy again shooting in the dark. We don't even understand the problem that we are trying to solve. What has been the case for the past few years, for a long time now, is that government have actually prioritized illegal immigrants over the South African youth. In many ways, I'll just make an example of the hospitality industry. That industry is overflowing with illegal immigrants while the South African youth is unemployed. So instead of dealing with the issue of illegal immigration, obviously these politicians are afraid of being criticized by mainstream media if they deal with this issue. So they just turn a blind eye on it. I've noticed that Caltex and SPAR have also joined in hiring illegal immigrants. For them, they don't care. It's just a cost-saving exercise. But South Africa and the youth of this country is suffering because the politicians are turning a blind eye on this issue as if it does not exist. In my opinion, we need some structural changes with some policy changes to turn around the issue of youth unemployment. One of the important things that we need to do is to lower the taxes so that we can entice investors to come and invest in this country. Because higher taxes mean that it's difficult for businesses to get their return on investment. And remove all other barriers, bureaucratic barriers, that makes it difficult to start and operate businesses here in the country. Still on tax, we need to reduce the middle class tax burden. These people need to have more disposable income so that they can go spend it in the economy. In that way, they will stimulate the economy and cause growth in the economy. That will in turn create a lot of job opportunities. And thirdly, I think we need to set the record straight about the property rights. No investor will come and spend billions of dollars here trying to establish a factory if at any time the government can just wake up and say we are expropriating a factory without compensation. So I think we need to set the record straight about the issue of property rights so that the investors have confidence that their investment is safe in this country. Right now, there's this uncertainty about property rights. Nobody knows really where the country is going. So people are holding back their investments and they're trying to figure out where the policy is going around the property rights. So we are busy delaying investment by not setting the record straight about property rights. Obviously, for anyone who's got half a brain to come and invest money in the country, they need some form of assurance that their investment is safe here. If they start a factory here, they need a certain assurance that the factory is theirs and the government will not wake up one day and make claims on that factory. So this is one of the fundamental things that is delaying investment into this country. Obviously, there's a lot of other issues that we need to solve to allow businesses to thrive in this country. One of those issues is the issue of Eskom load shedding. It was never mentioned at all how much Eskom is costing the economy through the load shedding, and how many jobs have been lost year by year through load shedding. So we need to put our house in order and try to stop this load shedding.